I just feel a lot of concern that 2024 may be the year of a black swan event. Mm-hmm. This is a national security event with high impact that's very hard to predict. There are a number of concerns.
George Orwell could not be more proud. The book he wrote, 1984, was supposed to be fictional, but it's all coming true. The Ministry of Truth is watching you. I'm the veteran biker. Facts over feelings. I don't care how you feel. I want you to know the truth. Sit down. This is where patriots watch YouTube. And if you say something out of line, you're gone. You're in an internment camp in Siberia. Well, we don't know where Catherine Herridge is, but I hope she's getting a lawyer. What you saw in that clip was Catherine Herridge, just a couple of weeks ago, talking about what she predicted as a black swan event, a very large event that could change, delay, or even delete the upcoming election. Catherine Herridge, now I say this very loosely, CBS reporter, I call it the CIA broadcasting system, CBS reporter, she was just fired. All of her files were seized. Now, this is nothing new because CBS is in a building called BlackRock. And BlackRock owns and controls, I think, 16% of CBS News. What's more troubling for those of you that like watching Fox is they own about 18% of Fox News. BlackRock owns what you're told, owns what you're told to believe. They control what news you're allowed to get. Just a couple of days ago, in one of the rare appearances by Joe Biden, not on vacation, he took some questions. There were a couple of questions asked about an FBI informant that was arrested.
An FBI informant at the center of the impeachment inquiry into you has been indicted for allegedly lying. Your reaction to that, and should the inquiry be dropped?
He is lying, and it should be dropped. And it's just been an outrageous effort from the beginning.
This FBI informant gave information about Burisma, about Ukraine, about some various other sort of deals for the big guy involving his son, Hunter Biden. And Joe, in this clip, says the investigation needs to go away. Immediately after this, Catherine Herridge was fired. There are no coincidences in politics. There are no coincidences at Wall Street. And many times, what happens in the White House, what happens in the Senate, what happens in the Congress has a direct reactive answer on Wall Street. So Joe Biden calls for the end of the investigation. Immediately afterwards, Catherine Herridge is fired. Catherine Herridge has been right at the front of the Hunter Biden investigation this entire time. And CBS News, maybe through pressure of the public, pressure of the viewer, has changed their tune over the last couple of years. I'm not sure why. Is it to get rid of Joe?
Experts say it has all the hallmarks of information laundering.
This looks like your classic disinformation campaign.
Eric O'Neill is a former FBI operative.
Steal the information with a cyber attack. Get the emails from Hunter Biden's account and then put them on these laptops that are left at a repair store. And that's how the information is now laundered into the public.
Who do you think is behind this?
Well, the Russians would be my number one guess.
The goal of these incidents appears to be the same, to cast a cloud over the front runner in the closing weeks of the campaign using a drip, drip, drip of emails that create the air of scandal, even though Republican-led congressional investigations have never uncovered any evidence of wrongdoing by Vice President Biden.
So that's CBS in 2020. And now you're going to see CBS currently, or a couple of weeks ago. Catherine's gone. They seized all of her files, all of her personal files. This is insane. This is 1940s Germany. This is 1960s Russia. We don't do this in the United States, or do we?
Confident, based on your analysis, this is Hunter Biden's data and that it's real.
Yes,
Lanterman and his son, Sean, both digital forensic experts, recovered images of credit cards, a driver's license, social security number.
Just the sheer volume of what we're dealing with, it would be difficult, if not impossible, to fabricate.
Mr. Biden has consistently denied knowledge of his son's work or financially benefiting from it.
I've never spoken to my son about drugs.
After 2 years of scrutiny, the laptop has not produced evidence President Biden directly benefited from his son's business deals.
We all know the media is complicit. Believe it if you want. It's true. The earth is round. Okay. There's many of you flat earthers that might be watching, and I really appreciate you tuning in. I need more crazies on here. I don't get enough troll comments. But the media is complicit. And when the big guy comes out and says, shut the investigation down, the machine starts turning its gears. BlackRock, we've already established in a previous video, is being anointed as the rebuilder of Ukraine. They are being anointed as the rebuilder of Gaza. So when the big guy says, shut the investigation down, somebody at BlackRock, probably a guy by the name of Larry, picks up the phone and says, hey, Hunter Biden reporter, fire her. That's what's happening. And that's why people like Tucker Carlson left Fox News, because they traded his career for the whole election interference story. That's what's happening. That is today in America. The media is complicit. The justice system, it's a system. I just don't know who the system is geared for. New York, Georgia. I mean, come on. We're seeing this every single day. That's why many of you watch people like me put out news on YouTube, on other platforms, because I'm unbiased. I don't care. I just want you to get the truth. This is where patriots watch YouTube. This is where patriots get their news, because you can't trust what's coming out. You're being given a little pill and you don't know what's in it. You're given a little nugget and you're just supposed to take it, accept it, like it. That's what's happening. I hope all of you hit the thumbs up, subscribe button. Know that your media is controlled, filtered, tampered, whatever. Whatever you want to call it, whatever will make you feel comfortable with understanding that the mainstream news is controlled. For all of you watching Fox News, you saw the graphic. BlackRock owns 18% of Fox News. So the next time you're watching Fox and Friends and you see Ainsley with nice legs, nice to look at in the morning, I'm not going to disagree with that. Wearing a cocktail dress at 5 a.m. is a little weird. You got Brian Kilmeade, looks like Bilbo Baggins, you know, like over there huffing and sweating and checking his Apple Watch. And you've got Steve Doocy, who is the most anti-President Trump, anti-MAGA movement that you could see on TV. It all starts to make sense. Things are starting to come together, aren't they? Right? There might be two wings, but it's all the same bird. CNN, Fox News, MSDNC, Newsmax, One America News, they're all the same. They're all controlled by their controlling investor. And it's more and more clear that that is BlackRock. Okay? That's what it is. Follow me over on Locals. It's kind of a backup plan. It's kind of a safe haven for YouTube. Check that out. Really appreciate all the support. I'm the veteran biker. I got to get up now and go to work. This is early in the morning. I make videos before I go to work. And now I've got to go and buy some iPhones for all the doctors and lawyers coming in through the southern border. So when they go to New York City and get a little handsy with the police, they can text their handlers, or they can call their public defenders, or they know how to go and get their $10,000 gift cards from Mayor Adams. I'm the veteran biker. I'm going to get out of here. I'm being facetious. But if you don't laugh at this, it'll give you an ulcer. It really would. You have to just let this simmer and soak and digest it. But everything you're being told when you turn on cable news is what they want you to hear. History books are written by the winners, and you're part of a history book right now. And there's certain people that will be the winners. It's 1984. Hey, where were you at in 1984? I think I was in like the fourth grade, fifth grade, something like that. I never would have thought 1984 would be so relevant. But it is now. It's really relevant now. Take care. Hit the like, subscribe button, thumbs up, all that jazz. Go check out some of the other videos. I'm doing a live stream on the weekends. Take care. Veteran Bikers out. See you on the road.